All right, so I watched Manti Te'o, the Untold series documentary on Netflix. This particular documentary was called The Girlfriend That Never Was. And I want to give you guys a little bit of backstory on Manti Te'o. He's an American football player and a very prolific one at that. One of the best tacklers that Notre Dame has ever seen, which Notre Dame is a very illustrious college football school. And at the peak of his fame at Notre Dame, he was caught in a scandal, if you could even call it that. And how I remember it when it was happening and how I'm able to now hear his side and this story, those two things combined, when I saw this, I felt compelled to make this video. And I don't know where I want to go with it, but I felt so strongly about it. The scandal was essentially him getting catfished. And back then, I think it was around 2015 or 2014, Instagram was like just getting going around colleges and kids were just getting going with social media. And I had an Instagram myself, and there was this thing that I did. I posted a picture, and this I no longer have this Instagram account, but I posted a picture with my arm around no one, and I said, Manti Te'oing. I think it was like hashtag Manti Te'oing. Got a bunch of laughs, probably got like 25 likes. And that was it. That was the exchange. The way that I remember Manti Te'o was, look at this joke. You know, the media portrayed him as such. And after that joke that I made about him, I said, fuck off. Fuck that guy. I don't care about him. He's just an athlete and he's kind of a clown. Like, screw this guy. And I saw that this documentary had been out and people said, you have to watch it. And I remember, you know, just recently telling them that same story and being like, yeah, you know, like the whole experience, it was funny to me and it was, you know, whatever. And they're like, you just got to watch it. You just got to watch it. And after I did watch it, my whole idea, everything flipped, everything switched. And I want to take the time to watch this ending with you guys again. And I don't, there might be spoilers here, but I think even if you watch this, you should watch the whole length thing. I haven't seen it since. I haven't seen the ending since. I just told Alex to procure the ending for me. I know this is going to be rough. I can already feel my emotions. I already feel the tension. So I'm just going to hit play.
And every time I was stepped on that line, that anxiety would build up again. Right? It's just like, don't mess up, bro. Like, don't mess up. Don't miss tackles. Like, are you sure you know what you're doing? Like, you know, and it was such a huge contrast to that kid at Notre Dame. The football field, that was my domain. You know, like when I'm on the football field, I feel like nobody can beat me. And I played free and I played fast and I played physical. And that was what made me great. Now I got to the NFL and I'm questioning everything.
So what happened when he was at Notre Dame was obviously the catfishing scandal, and the most shocking thing was he was up for a Heisman, and the Heisman Trophy is like so illustrious. It's the MVP of college football. It is a very, very big deal. And after being up for it and a finalist for it, he didn't win it. But he was picked in the second round, which the difference between a second round pick and a first round pick is millions of dollars. And he was a shoo-in for the first round without this scandal. So now he's been drafted. He's playing for the San Diego Chargers, which is a professional football team. And he is not comfortable playing football. And for him, no matter what the outside world was like, when he played football, he was the most comfortable he could have been.
I do remember covering games where he would come out of the tunnel and people would heckle him. And it just became something that he could never escape.
What happened was what happened, and what I'm here to do is play football, and hopefully, you know, guys saw that. He changed so much. He withdrew himself.
Then the memes started coming out. The paper in San Diego came out with a cartoon of him with his armor on nobody.
And so I remember telling my friends when they said about this documentary, I remember telling them that I did this, and I kind of had this like pridefulness to it. Like I had done something, like I was a part of that meme, that historical meme. And I can't tell you guys how much seeing this changed at everything.
Every day was just trying to figure out how to get rid of this anxiety, how to get rid of this numbness, this tingling, right? I'm trying to figure out all these ways to reprogram myself, right? I'm watching inspirational talks. I'm watching old film of me. I'm trying to rediscover who I was before everything. I started calling my agent up, and I told my agent, I was like, Tom, like, I need to see somebody. I was like, I don't know what I have, but it's something new, and I need help. My agent sent me to see this therapist, and we're just talking in the lobby, just getting to know each other, and I'm kind of laying down what's going on, you know? And in the back of my head, I'm like, nobody has a cure for this, man. Like, this guy he's not gonna help me. And at the end, he says, let me ask you a question. Have you forgiven him? I said, what are you talking about? He said, have you forgiven Renaya for what he did to you? And I said, yeah, I did. I said, okay.
So Renaya was the name of the, at the time, man, now currently woman. And look, I'm not going to misgender someone. If they want to be called a gender, I'm going to call them that. You can hate on me all you want in the comment section. I really don't care. For the sake of this video, knowing that this is a transitioned woman, we're going to call her a woman. Renaya was the catfisher. I believe you would call it the catfisher, being Manti Te'o was the catfish-y.
So, okay. Let me ask you a second question. Have you forgiven yourself? And I looked at him and said, what do you mean forgive myself? He's like, have you forgiven yourself? He's like, forgiven myself for what? He's like, somebody like you who's always been so confident, who's never questioned anything that he's done, and has all his success has been based on him trusting in him. For you to go through what you went through, deep down inside, you're questioning yourself. You have to forgive that kid. It's okay, Us. What happened to you is not your fault. It's okay. Forgive that kid. The key is this. There's always gonna be that little kid that's gonna come up to you because he loves you. But if you look at that little kid, like the way that this dude just treated you, you're gonna ruin that little kid. That is my challenge every day. That when somebody comes up to me and they say, Manti, man, I'm a big fan of you, that I don't think of the times of the hundreds of people that say, Manti, I'm a big fan of you, let me take a picture. And I took a picture with them and they made fun of me. If there's anything that I can do, that's what I'm gonna do every day. You know? I'm gonna rise above all of that, bro. No matter how hard it is for me. I'm gonna look at all these people who made fun of me and the people who actually believe in me. I have to take a second to be like, they actually love me, man. They love you. They don't want to make fun of you, bro. Treat them nice in a world that's just spit on you. Remember all those people in the stands that had the lace on. Because you're going to have hundreds and thousands and millions of people that touch you. It ain't worth nothing, man. But there's going to be one that's going to say, you're worth the world to me. And I play for that person.
Yeah.
I'll take all this crap. I'll take all the jokes. I'll take all the memes so that I can be an inspiration to one who needs me to be. That's the whole reason why I'm doing this. And I want everybody to know that if Renaya ever watched this, that I forgive her. Hope and pray that him and his family's cool. Because that's all that I can wish for.
I don't know. I had to talk about this. It's amazing how we treat people when they're down. And it's amazing how all we have to do is give them a chance to talk or hear from them. But there's something about this that means so much to me, and that is to take everyone that enjoys your company, who has ever said anything or felt that you are important to them, and treat them like they are everything, because they really are. In doing that, you are respecting yourself, because all that person is doing is holding some mirror up to you and saying, look how much you're loved, look how much people care about you, you know? So if any of you ever struggle with stuff, think about that. And fuck, man. Jesus Christ. And just keep fucking marching, man. Like, one step, take a step. Take another step, take another step. If you're a weightlifter, if you're a powerlifter, if you're into fitness, if you're into anything, do the small thing that is directly in front of you. And if you do that, you can do the next small thing. It might be a little bit bigger. And you keep going until you get the shit done that you want. And you will thank your previous self. You will thank the person, the version of yourself that did those things, because now you get to live with those abilities. I appreciate all of you so much for watching. I will continue. We're going to continue. Love you.